Hey guys, it's Cynthia and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sitting on the floor and I'm wearing my pajamas just because today is Saturday and I just wanted to make it a little bit more casual. As you can see from the title, today I'm going to be sharing my story on my eating disorder. Some of you guys might be surprised, but to be honest, not many people know. I don't really talk about it because it is something that makes me feel embarrassed. And it is not something you would share on a normal basis, you know? Recently, I was very inspired by a US gymnast called Caitlin Ohashi. If you follow me on my Instagram, you probably already see some of the story that I posted. If you're interested, I will leave the documentary down below. But without further ado, let's get into my story. It feels weird to just put myself out there and just tell you guys that, oh guys, I have eating disorder. So let's talk about how I started. I grew up dancing and I danced like ballet and contemporary martial arts and etc. I grew up going to those like special classes at school where we spend a couple hours a day to dance. So I go through the whole system from elementary school to middle school to high school. When I was 15, during my last year of middle school, I was so determined to go to this school that I really wanted to go to. That school was known for accepting people who have like really good body shape, great techniques, pretty good academics scores. In general, it was a tough school to get into. I remember I was 15 and we would go on the scales every week to weigh ourselves. I was told that if you lose a couple kilograms, I think you have a chance to go to your dream school. So I started this whole like weight loss journey. Keep in mind that when I was 15, all the information that I could get were probably from the internet, and I just follow all different kind of like weight loss recipes, and like I don't eat carbs, I don't eat dinner, I don't like eat snacks or drinks or whatever, and some of them are healthy, some of them are not so healthy, but I couldn't really tell the difference and I just kept going. In the end, I lost 5 kilograms in 3 months and I didn't eat dinner for, I would say, 3 or 4 months straight. So my period came at 15, which is exactly the time when I started to lose weight. And that means that I lost a period for the next a year and a half. I started feeling very weak all the time. I even fainted once at the convenience store without knowing like what exactly happened. I just remember I felt very dizzy and I just don't remember the rest of it. I was happy that I lost weight and I got into the school that I won, which was great. But things started getting very unhealthy. When I got into the dream school, which is an art school, you are surrounded by girls and boys who have like the best body shape ever. Like, I'm not gonna lie, like everyone around me has such a good body shape. They have long legs, they're skinny, they have perfect flexibilities and physical ability, and I just feel like I am so like below average, you know? When you are in that environment, you start comparing yourself to other people, especially when you're at like 15 or 16, which is the most sensitive year you could ever been. Gaining some weight was actually what I needed because my body was just so bad at this point where I go to the doctor and they told me that I don't have enough nutrients in my body, I don't have enough like hormones to keep my period going. But when I was 16, I was so sad and upset about my own body. My body was not responding well. I'm very conscious about gaining weight. So when I was trying to balance these two ideas, I just thought to myself like, oh, what if I eat and I just don't eat at all? I still get part of the nutrition, but I don't get that much of the calories. That was the most stupid idea ever, but that's when I started developing this habit of throwing out food after I eat. And at first, it was like once a week or twice a week. Eventually, it became every single meal, every single day. I have actually never, you know, tried to get the food out of my system using my hands or any other stuff, but it's just a natural reaction that was developed by my own body, that every time I eat, I just have that feeling and urge to throw everything out. I know that sounds like, can you not control it? And no, I couldn't control it, and I feel so much better afterwards. I think that has something to do with my mental health and mental state that was so unstable that I couldn't control myself at all. After a couple months, my friend actually found out that I was vomiting food after I eat, and that was a big deal in the dance department because it was actually very common in the industries of like modeling or like dancers because we have to keep on a certain shape. They told me to find this like mental health counselors at school, just like go there once or twice a week just to talk about about my feelings and why I'm doing that and how can we, you know, move from that. But actually it was such a bad idea because, you know, like when you're 16 or 17, you don't want to be the only one that's different from other people. And I was the only one who has to go to counselors every week. People would look at me like, oh my gosh, is she sick? And why is she going to like this mental health thing. I never really opened my mind to the counselors. I saw it as an assignment, so I just go there because my teachers told me to do so. And eventually my mom knows about it and she threatened me that if you continue to do this, and I will transfer you out of the school because this school is giving you a very hard time. It's not healthy. It's not worth it, basically. The good thing is, I think I got better on the last year of my high school. I gained a lot of self-confidence due to a very good friend of mine. I really appreciate her company during that time. After graduating from the art school, I decided to quit dancing and go to college in the States. That was a whole new world. I started realizing that not everyone is skinny and it's not a standard of beauty because beauty doesn't have a standard. As long as you are confident about yourself, you are beautiful. I was actually pretty okay and I thought that, you know, like I recovered. I've never gone to an actual doctor for this matter and I think I did a good job dealing with it. When I graduated from college, it was such a bad time for me. I just graduated from college. I just ended a relationship not long ago. I was still concerning where my career would go. I'm not sure where I should be, like America or in Asia. There's just so much thing that I couldn't have control. And that gradually kind of stressed me out a little bit and my mental state became very unstable again. I started isolating myself from other people, from all social activities. I don't want to have any interactions with people, even though I was so sad. I was so upset about like everything for no reason. And I realized that one thing that would de-stress me and pull me out of that hole was by eating. I was still very conscious about how I look and my body shape and stuff. So I started developing a very serious eating disorder. It was like the most serious eating disorder I've ever had, where I would just go to like fast food drive-thru and I would buy like meals that's enough for like 3 to 4 people. I would just munching in and just eat and eat and eat until my stomach starting to hurt. If you're wondering that how can you eat so much food, to be honest, I don't know. Because when I was eating, I couldn't feel anything. Literally, I couldn't stop the action of eating. Now I think about it, it was so scary. The feeling of you cannot control yourself of doing something that you know that is harmful to you. I was clear that I was sick. That was just not right, you know? Fast forward to current time. It has been like 8 or 9 years since I started developing this really bad habit. And if you ask me if I am okay now, if I have recovered, I would have to be honest and say, no, I haven't. But I have also learned how to control myself. Some of you guys may know that I started doing yoga and that played a big part of me because yoga helped me to be grounded and to be real with my body and how I feel. And also I have developed some more confidence about my body. I don't feel as ashamed of wear like waist 28 jeans or I have to buy like medium size or large size at a store. Well, it sounds very cheesy, but Ian often told me that I am beautiful and I already have a boyfriend who doesn't think I'm fat. Then why would I trying to beat myself up and don't believe that I'm ugly and just fat? I think overall I have just become a stronger person and I'm very proud of myself. Well, I shouldn't be proud of myself because I haven't fully recovered, but I'm proud of, you know, becoming a stronger person. But if you have struggles like this, I think it's so important to go to an actual doctor just to consult them and just see where you can start improving yourself. It is also important to develop your confidence in yourself, just to believe that you are beautiful and you can do whatever you want. You don't have to care about other people. I am not an expert. I am not a professional. I'm not a psychologist. So please do not take this video as a official medical reference because it is not. The main goal of the video is to share my story because of the body image that I was so obsessed with. I developed this eating disorder and I believe that there are so many girls and boys are stressing themselves because of that. And if your friends told you that you're fat and just look down on you just because how you look, then I think they're not real friends. You are the only one who can solve the fundamental problems. I also want to say that I want to raise the awareness about eating disorder because it is part of a mental illness. People don't talk about it that often just because it is kind of embarrassing to talk about it. I feel like I have just like rumbling for 30 minutes now. It is my third time filming this video because I literally could not stand myself for the previous two times. But this is an English talking sesh. Kind of like it. That's all for today's video. I hope this video would be helpful for some of you guys and just, you know, be happy. Tomorrow is another day and I love you guys so much and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!
Hold me close and hold me fast. This magic spell you cast. This is La Vie en Rose. When you kiss me, heaven sighs. And though I close my eyes,